Hello everyone, my name is Eduardo Mendoza. I'm from Brazil. Yes, this big country on South Asia, right? Of course not. It's the largest country in the South America. Yes, my first language is Portuguese. Brazil is the only country in the South America that speaks Portuguese. I'm very happy with that. Make us a little bit unique on that point. And today I'm going to be working with you. I'm going to be sharing a little bit about the street rhythm of my country. The rhythm I'm going to be learning today, it's called the samba reggae. Samba, the most popular Brazilian rhythm, and the reggae, that's not Brazilian rhythm. Where is the reggae from? Oh yeah, if you say Jamaica, it's great. If you did not say that, it's pretty close. Now you all know it's a Jamaica, right? And one of the most popular Jamaican singers and the composers is Bob Marley. Mm-hmm. There's a few songs that you know from Bob Marley, like "No Woman, No Cry." That's a reggae. There's another one too, like that. "Don't Worry About a Thing, 'Cause Every Little Thing is Gonna Be Alright." Yeah. So this rhythm starts in Brazil. The late 70s and the early 80s, what a group of young people, they get together on the streets and say, yeah, let's create something new. And yes, they did it. They blend together some elements of samba and they put together some element of the reggae music. And then they created this new rhythm called the samba reggae. Okay? There's a few ways to play the samba reggae. I'm going to be sharing one of them today. And for drums, guess what? You're gonna be using cookingware, cooking pots. That's gonna be our drums for today. It's very easy to find, right? And I'm gonna be using that as my drums, see? And I'm gonna be also putting together here a paper towel on top of them, just to muffle a little bit the sound. Otherwise, you could have something like this, if I can muffle a little bit with a paper towel. Could be like a piece of fabric, could be maybe like a t-shirt or anything that you want to muffle a little bit the sound. You see that the difference? Just a little bit. Yeah, and right now we're gonna be also doing the same thing for another one. So you don't have to actually do like very well, just put it on top. And here another one, here you go. So I'm gonna be called now my drums I'm gonna be called my drums by numbers. Okay, this one here on my left, that's gonna be on your right, because you're gonna be my mirror, right? My left is gonna be your right. And here we're gonna be my right will be your left. So I'm gonna be called this one here number one. I'm gonna be here this one here number two. Okay, and the little one here in the center, number three. So the number one and number two, we're gonna be play the quarter notes when I count. And one, two, one, two, one, two. You can actually move like from your right and left, right and left. That make you more connected with the rhythm. For the surdo number three, we're gonna do a different part, like that. Yeah, if I sing the rhythm, it goes like that. Boom, pa, boom, pa, 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 boom, boom, pa, boom, pa, 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 boom. Boom, pa, boom, pa, 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 boom, boom, pa, boom. Yes, okay, pretty good. So now you see the number three sometimes play the 8 notes and sometimes goes on 16 notes, right? And then now if you observe, the number three is played very often with one of these drums, number one or number two. Take a look and let me know which one you think is playing more often. The number three play more often with the number one or number two. Ready? Here you go. which number? Yes, if you say the number 2 is correct. If you do not say the number 2, that's fine. You can make mistakes, that's fine. But yes, we play together more often with the number 2. Okay, now for the samba reggae, let's working in the call. Brazilian rhythm, there's a lot of call and response. And our intro will be something like that. My little drums here on my table, gonna do something like that. Pa pa pra-ra-ka-ta. Let's say again. Pa pa pra-ra-ka-ta. Let me sing the rhythm. Pa pa pra-ra-ka-ta. Let's do it again. Pa pa pra-ra-ka-ta. One more time. Pa pa pra-ra-ka-ta. One more time, and I say go and you do it together with me, okay? Go, pa, pa, pra-ra-ka-ta. Beautiful. One more time, just make sure. Pa, pa, pra-ra-ka-ta. Yes, okay? So, in the Brazilian music, in the Brazilian popular music, Brazilian street music, everything is more passed orally. So people is not like too connected, who is the one, who is the two, who is the off beat, nothing that. But I'm gonna be give you some, just a little tips about how you can connect that with the music. And then if you count, it's a 2-4, 1-2, 1-2. When you start to the call, you're gonna be the offbeat. Pa pa pra-ra-ka-ta, right? Here you go, let's count again. 1-2, 1-go. Pa pa pra-ra-ka-ta. Beautiful. That's the call. Okay, let's do it again. 1-2, 1-go. Pa pa pra-ra-ka-ta. Yes! Okay, now I gotta be count and you do yourself. Here you go. 1-2, 1, go. Oh, yes. Okay. Now the response. For the response, both drums. You have like two hands, of course, but can do with the 1 or 2 or 1 and 3 or 2 and 3. Whatever drum you pick will be fine because the response you're gonna be hit twice. Ta ta. Okay, like that. Let me play for you. 1, 2, 1. Pa pa pra-ra-ka-ta, pum pum. You see, I made a mistake. Let me do it again because I have to sing the call and they respond by hit the drums twice. Here you go. Pa pa pra-ra-ka-ta. Yes, okay? I can choose this one, for example. Pa pa pra-ra-ka-ta. Yes. Uh-huh. And then let's now do the call and the response. Together. 1, 2, 1. And pa pa pra-ra-ka-ta. Pa pa pra-ra-ka-ta. Pa pa pra-ra-ka-ta. Pa pa pra-ra-ka-ta. Yes. Okay, now let's start the rhythm. Okay, when I say and, I'm gonna be hit the 1 and 2, and then the number 3 gonna be start right after 2 and the offbeat. Okay, like that. Pa pa pra-ra-ka-ta, boom, boom. 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 And 1. Yes, you see, it's a lot of fun, right? I think it's fun. And now, let's talk about the outro. The outro will be the same thing I did at the beginning. Pa, pa, pra-ra-ka-ta, boom, boom. That's gonna be our outro, okay? Here we go. The only difference is, right in the beginning, nobody's playing, because say, pa, pa, pra-ra-ka-ta, boom, boom, right? Pa, pa, pra-ra-ka-ta, boom, boom. However, for the outro, we're gonna be actually playing through, like this, right? When you hear the call, you don't stop. Wait for me. Pa pa para pa pa. Got that? Yes. Now let's do everything from top. We're gonna do the intro. We're gonna do the body of the rhythm, and we're gonna do the outro. Ready? Here you go. 1, 2, 1, and pa pa para kata. Pa pa para kata. Pa pa pra-ra-ka-ta. Pa pa pra-ra-ka-ta. And 1. pa pa paracata. Yes, you got everything. So now to finish, to conclude, let's put something else in here. Also, the intro and outro could be breaks in between. I can do breaks in between. And this time, when I'm gonna do the breaks in between, I'm gonna be saying something like solo. If I say solo, and then you can throughout the break, and then you can create a few things here. Be creative. You can hit the table. You can hit with drums. Another one. Just use your imagination. Give you wings to your imagination. When they're gonna say and pa pa pra kata pum pum, and they're gonna be go back to the rhythm. Okay, let's see. Let's see how that works. Okay, let's do the intro, the rhythm, solo part, like you do your improvisation, and then back to the rhythm and the outro. Let's see how that works. Pa pa pra kata, pa pa pra kata, pa pa pra kata. Pa pa pra kata and pa pa pra kata pum pum. Pa pa pra kata pum pum. Pa pa pra kata pum pum. Solo. Pa 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 ta ta pum pum. Pa pa kata kata pum pum. Ta ka ta ta kata pum pum. Ta ka kata kata pum pum. Ta ka kata kata pum pum. Ta ka ta ka kata pum. Your turn. Pa pa pra kata pum pum. Pa pa pra kata pum pum. Do your solo. Ta ta tra kata. I'm watching you. Ta ta tra kata. Ta ta tra-ka-ta, ta ta tra-ka-ta, and one, pa ta 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 ta. Wow! I hope you learned something new today. Something that you can do some improvisation, you can create something when you do the breaks in between. You can ask people to come together and they play with you. It's not necessarily I play one, two, and three, or you play one, two, and three, but you can have like a bunch of people only hit the beat one, another group of people only hit the beat two, another group of people, pa. You can be creative and they see how you can break down this rhythm for a group to play. So, before I go, let me ask you to remind me the name of the rhythm that you just learned, this Brazilian street rhythm. Yeah, there is a combination of the two rhythms. One is a samba from Brazil, another one is reggae from Jamaica. Thank you so much. That was very nice to be here with you. And let's say goodbye on my first language in Portuguese, okay? Here you go. Tchau. Tchau. Now, let me hear you. One, two, three. Yes. Tchau.